What's happening out there, people? It's Roll Easy here, and I'm back with yet another GTA 5 Online video. We have a solo money glitch to show you. Now, sorry I'm getting this to you now. I had a few things to do today, but I'm back and I'm able to make this video for you guys. Now, it took me a little while to hit this glitch. This is not the easiest glitch out there. It's not even close to an easy glitch. Definitely not a glitch for newbies and people with not a lot of money, and definitely, you know, watch out you intermediate glitchers or even good glitchers, because this glitch could give you some problems. Now, I'm going to give you the best tips I can to try to hit it the best way, but just beware, this is not an easy solo money glitch by no means, okay? So the founder of this was Morphe over on Seven Sins. Morphe does great stuff for the PC players, and he found this, so shout out to you, Morphe. Now, what you need is a facility, and you want it to be full, okay? What you see me doing right here, I'm actually just overriding a retro just because I really don't need it. But yeah, I'm going to be putting a streetcar in its place, and you're going to see why. Now, it's similar to the gift cards to friends glitch with a lot more added steps, okay? It's kind of a mashing of a lot of different glitches, but it's a pretty good one, all right? Once you get the hang of it. So like I said, a full facility, we're going to be putting a streetcar in there eventually. Also, you will need to spend money. That's why I said, for you newbie glitchers and people that aren't rich, I don't recommend this glitch very much. I really don't, all right? And it's going to give you a lot of hassle. You're going to need this dump truck, okay? This dump truck costs $1 million. I didn't even have it yet, all right? I had to actually buy it just to do this glitch. So there is a good amount of setup and money. Along with that, you need a phantom wedge. So if you don't got a phantom wedge, you got to spend an extra, it might be like $2 million for a phantom wedge. I'm not sure. I bought mine a while ago. But anyways, what you see me doing right here actually is, and you also need to sign in as a motorcycle club president and obviously a retro, you know, a Benny's vehicle to dupe. And you need custom plates for this. This is a custom plates glitch, okay? So what you see me doing right here, I'm actually, you see my facility's full. That's how you want it. I'm bringing in a streetcar. Doesn't matter what it is, okay? You just need a streetcar that is uninsured, all right? Just like that gift cards to friends, you need an uninsured streetcar in your facility. So I'm gonna go ahead and put it in this slot right here where I had just ordered that RH8. Now I have a full facility. There's a streetcar in there. We're ready to continue with the glitch. So once I head back outside, what I need to do now is actually call up for the two main vehicles to do this glitch. First one is the Phantom Wedge, okay? And you can do this in either order, right? But we need to call out the Phantom Wedge and the dump truck, okay? And get those in position. Now, you don't see me doing it right here. What I would recommend to everybody, before you hop into any vehicles, and by the way, I did this in an invite-only session if you really care, right? It's a solo glitch. Might as well do it in an invite-only. I recommend opening up your interaction menu before entering all vehicles, to be honest with you. Even before you start getting glitched out, just interaction menu open for all vehicles. This footage right here was from the first fail, but it's all the setup. But yeah, I recommend opening the interaction menu. You want to park the Phantom Wedge kind of like you see me doing right here. Okay, and you see interaction menu open so I don't get sucked into the facility. But the Phantom Wedge, we're going to be using that wedge right there on the front to actually flip our vehicle. Okay, it'll all make sense once we get there. There's a good amount of setup to do before you even get started with this. Okay, so now what you want to do is call up the Pegasus vehicle, which is the dump truck that we just bought for $1 million. Okay, so you see where it says dump right there? That's the dump truck. All right, so go ahead and call up the dump truck, drive over there. Like I said, I recommend opening interaction menu before entering all vehicles during this glitch, no matter what point you are. Okay, the time I was able to hit it at the end of the video, that's what I was doing. Before entering every single vehicle, I had the interaction menu open. Pretty sure it works the same way if you open up your phone. But anyways, this is where you want to park the dump truck, okay? Park the dump truck on top of the facility. That was a little bit too close, so I ended up hopping back in, and I'm actually going to back it up. You don't want it too close to the front of the facility where the yellow circle is, okay? Because it could make it despawn. So I recommend just go ahead and back it up to that. Around right there is pretty good. Nothing should happen to it there. So now that we've gotten our two main vehicles to set up, you need to go grab a streetcar. This is where it becomes tricky and very important. You need to grab an SUV, okay? Preferably the ones that will work the best. This one might not work the best, but you see that interaction menu open and then I hop in the vehicle. What you need to be grabbing are cars, SUVs, things that are high up off the ground. The BF Injector is a really good one. It's got those big, you know, off-road tires. The Sand King is a good one. Even this one, the Patriot right here, might not have big tires, but it's high up on the ground, so it's easy to flip. So this is what we're doing. With the interaction menu open, the plan is to actually use that wedge to flip the car up on its side like that, okay? But what you need to be doing is, that was just a test run. You need to close the interaction menu right when you get flipped, and then you should get a full alert. You're gonna accept it. Now, Here is where the trickiness comes in. This is probably the hardest part of the glitch. Okay, the trickiness is you need to accept that when the vehicle is on its side, okay, it needs to be on its side. If it's, and I mean literally on the side of the car, if it's just up on two wheels, you're gonna get sucked into the facility and then you're gonna have to set up the Phantom Wedge again and get another streetcar. Okay, so you're gonna see right here actually on this attempt. So this is a fail right here, and I want to show you how you have to be on your side. So look, close the interaction menu, accept it, but look at that. I'm only on two wheels, and I get sucked into the facility when I accept the alert. That's why you literally need to be up on your side when accepting that. Now here's an example of a success right here. This is the BF injector. Look at that. So you see how it gets popped up on the side right there? The key is drive up to that side of the Phantom Wedge super slow, okay? And then just speed up right before you hit it, okay? So look, super slow, speed up, accept the alert. And look at that. You see? If you accept the alert and nothing happens, you did it right, okay? If you didn't get sucked in, you did it right. Just hop out of the car and continue with the glitch. Now I ended up failing here. My dupe didn't get sucked into the facility. So I'm gonna show you right here the successful attempt. All right, I actually hit the glitch with this SUV, surprisingly. I didn't expect to, but you have to reposition the Phantom Wedge so that, and I don't know why I can't get into it in that angle, but you need to reposition the Phantom Wedge in the right place for the right vehicle, okay? Like I said, the easiest ones to use are the Sand King XL and the BF injector, because they got these off-road tires and they're really high up on the ground, so they're easy to flip over, all right, mad easy. But I'm gonna show you, you can actually do it with an SUV, just like a normal little SUV like you see me doing right here. Like I said, the key is position the Phantom Wedge correctly, make sure your interaction menu is open up, and then go ahead and speed up a little bit right before you hit it. Right when I'm on my side, you accept it. So that was a test run. I wanted to make sure I'd be able to do it. This is more than capable of hitting it, okay? So here we go, interaction menu's still up. I'm gonna go slowly, then hit the gas, and then boom, accept it. Do you see that? I'm perfectly on my side. I knew that I was gonna get it. If nothing happens, you're good to go. Just open up the interaction menu again so you don't get sucked in, and there we go, okay? So now that you've successfully gotten that part done, which is the hardest part of the glitch, I will admit, go ahead and call up your mechanic, and you're actually gonna be requesting the vehicle. Remember that street vehicle that we put inside of the facility that's uninsured? You're gonna be calling that up. So you see Route 68 facility, I believe it was the Seminole right in there that I did put in earlier in the glitch. And we're simply just gonna blow this vehicle up, okay? That's why we want it to be uninsured. All right, so once I get it called up and it's on the minimap, there it is. I'm gonna go ahead, you could throw a sticky, you know, shoot an RPG at it, whatever you wanna do, but just blow it up. So personal vehicle's been destroyed, we're good to go. Now what you wanna do is call up your retro custom or whatever Benny's vehicle you're duplicating that has a custom plate. Now I recommend just being signed in as the motorcycle club president, okay, the entire time. It's probably easier to be. So now this is where you want to position the dump truck that we left there earlier in the glitch. So go ahead and just get that streetcar out of the way. Just push it out of the way so it's not bothering you, you know, for the rest of the glitch right here. Now you want to park your dump truck the way that you see me parking it right here. So check it out. Basically center of the facility with the front two wheels hanging right off the edge of the facility, okay? So the yellow circle basically is right under the front of that dump truck. Okay, and remember, interaction menu open before entering all vehicles in the glitch. Hugely important. Interaction menu always open before entering vehicles. Okay, so my retro is down there. I have the cops on me, so I'm just gonna call Lester and get him off. I don't want anybody to deal with me or, you know, to piss me off while I'm doing this glitch or to mess up with it, because that part was hard enough to hit with the Phantom Wedge, okay? So I'm gonna get down here to my retro custom. Remember, it must have a custom plate. And look at that, interaction menu opened up before I got into the vehicle. Super important, guys, all right? Or else you won't get sucked in with the dupe. Now, what you wanna do is go ahead and park it under the dump truck right here. So the yellow circle would be right there. If you press Y or triangle, you should just teleport right out. So you see that? And only teleport out once, all right? That's it. If you teleport out once, you're good. Now, hover over return vehicle to storage. Xbox, hit A and Y at the same time. PlayStation, hit X and triangle, and you should teleport in and then automatically get sucked into the facility. Okay, just like that, guys. I would say bing boom bomb easy. No, it's not easy. All right, it took me forever to get this footage, but it does work, and it is a solo money glitch. But like I said, intermediate guys still might have some trouble. Newbies will probably have a lot of trouble at this, and you might not have the money to start up Phantom Wedge, dump truck, facility. You need a lot for this glitch, okay? But that is how you hit it, all right? And when you spawn in, just like that gift cards to friends, your retro custom, your dupe, will already be in that spot. You see that? The yellow one, it's already in that spot. So what you do right now is you just cancel the replace alert, because you would actually be replacing with a streetcar. So just cancel that alert and then accept it, you know, cancel it and then confirm the cancellation. And there you go, you have your duplicate inside of your facility. All right, so biggest tips to take from this glitch: opening up interaction menu every time before you enter a vehicle, have your MC Motorcycle Club, you know, just be signed in the entire time. Those are really, really important. The streetcar you pick, make sure it's an SUV, and the positioning of the Phantom Wedge is very, very important. All right. And as for all these facility glitches, remember, when you pull these vehicles out, they will be bricked. You can either close game and restart, or you can swap to your second character and swap back to your first to gain full access. And as you can see, my custom plate right here on the dupe, this is a clean duplicate and it is good to sell once I can gain access to it. All right, but that's gonna be it for me, guys. I was as detailed and thorough as I could be with this glitch. I hope that you enjoyed the video and possibly learned how to do this. Give it a try. Let me know what you think down in the comments. And yeah, so make sure to subscribe to the channel if you're brand new by hitting that big red button. Turn on post notifications and drop a fat like on this video and the rest of my videos for the freshest and the most informative dope GTA 5 online content. Road to 25,000 subscribers. Peace out.